Don't Drink and Drown is the Royal Life Saving Society UK's national campaign that encourages smart decision making whilst intoxicated around water. Hashtag be a mate.
Yeah, don't worry guys, I'm gonna go the canal route. It's way quicker.
Okay mate, if you're good, yeah? Okay, I'll see you later, man.
Come on mate, don't be stupid. Let's just stick together, alright?
Don't Drink and Down campaign is a national campaign that's been run by the United Kingdom and Ireland Royal Life Saving Society for the last 4 or 5 years. And what it basically aims to do, it sets out to promote literally don't drink and drown. In other words, it highlights the seriousness of the very high percentage of people who actually end up in the water after they've been drinking. And many, many times it's accidentally ending up in the water. And in actual fact, each year, there's an average of about 70 odd people sadly do drown. That's about 20% who've been drinking heavily beforehand. Throughout the campaign nationally, we publicise the facts that I'm talking about. And then locally in Brighton and Hove over the last 4 or 5 years, what we've done is we've taken volunteers from our Coastal Forum group, who are a group of volunteers and workers that are based in Brighton, Seafront Office, the Brighton Beach Patrol, the Fire Brigade, the RNLI, the Coast Guards, and our own volunteers from the Royal Life Saving Society. We go down onto the Brighton Seafront and we spend a whole night down there where we're distributing leaflets, talking to people. Last year on the pier here, we spent one whole night on freshers weekend with the new students, talking to them and handing out leaflets. We have wristbands that we distribute. We've had the cooperation of the licensed premises that are the nightclubs on the seafront, and they've shown our posters, distributed our leaflets. We work with the Brighton Crime Reduction Partnership and go in on a Friday night where we'll talk to the door security supervisors and they in turn will be looking out for those that may well be potential victims. And then the patrol on the beach is carried out mainly by the Brighton Beach Patrol because it's night time, but the volunteers jump in on it as well and spread out and manage to add additional manpower or lady power, whichever you prefer, onto the beach to intervene in those cases where there's a potential for a problem. And it's a concentration at the beginning of December that we've found is the busiest time that we can do it in. Although also we come down for Pride weekend and do exactly the same then. And there's a very, very high concentration of people who've been, shall we say, intervened with, who were either going into the water late at night or were already in the water and potentially needed help. So again, that's another typical time when numbers are very high. I used to work as the police licensing officer inspector for Brighton and Hove back in the late 80s and early 90s. I've counted 3,000 people on the beach at night at 3 o'clock in the morning. It can get very, very busy. And that's why we come down and promote this Don't Drink and Drown campaign. The To Be a Mate is about where somebody who perhaps has been drinking, might be depressed, could be vulnerable for other reasons. It's about making sure that you look after them and don't leave them alone. And indeed, the film that we're showing this year, the video clip, talks about a young man who, it's based on fact, was left by his mates to find his own way home and fell in a canal and passed away as a result. And the same thing can happen elsewhere. if you're not looking after your friends who've perhaps become intoxicated, then they could get into trouble if they're near water.